Hey guys, welcome to the next video for the distal shuffle. In the previous final conclusion of the KDE environment in Architect from Manjaro, I said I would install Void Linux on the laptop with the GNOME desktop environment. I had some issues with it because I tried to boot from the USB device on my laptop and I didn't get it. So it didn't start from the USB. I downloaded it again, checked it, put it on the USB drive again with DD, boot it. No luck. And then I tried to download the official live CD from the Cinnamon desktop because I saw that on Void Linux, if you go to the download page, you have a couple of supported desktop environment, but not GNOME. So you have XFCE, Mate, LXQT, LXDE, Cinnamon, and Enlightenment. So I downloaded the Cinnamon one, tried to boot from that one, and it didn't work either. I still want to review Void Linux with the GNOME desktop environment. So what I did was download the ISO, the normal ISO from here. And I downloaded this ISO here. And I just created the virtual machine. Should be working in this week. So what we're gonna do is install Void Linux in a virtual machine, and then we're gonna install the GNOME desktop environment. So if I go back to my file browser, there is an installation instruction for it, so it doesn't look that difficult. So we're gonna just try it, install it on the machine. A couple of things: you have the GNOME apps, Mesa driver, because virtual machine, I will install that one. Also, install this later. And we're gonna set up some links for the network manager, DDM, and then that is done. We're gonna link the dbus session, GNOME service. Yeah, we're going through that installation. So let's go and open Virtual Machine Manager. We're gonna create a new machine here. So Void Linux, click it. We're gonna say Void Linux, automatically detect operating system. It says it has not that much memory needed, but I'm gonna give it 4 gig of my memory and 4 CPUs of my 8 CPUs installed on this system. I've took my normal power horse, the laptop that I'm using. That's the System76 Data Pro that I'm using for normal daily work, and I'm gonna install it on here. So that I'm not doing it on the AMD system with a lot of memory, and so I just wanted to do it on a normal laptop. I'm gonna give the disk 30 gig. I do want to use UEFI mode, so I'm gonna customize installation. Get it to UEFI. And we're gonna begin the installation. I'm gonna go full screen. And we're gonna start it. The installation of Void is pretty straightforward and not that difficult. a couple of things where you need to take into account. Overall, it seems pretty good. So once you boot it, you get here and you can see that the user for the root and then the password is void Linux. So we're gonna use that one and use root and then void Linux. And then it says okay, start the void installer. So void dash installer. And it's gonna start the installer. So click OK. We're gonna set the keyboard. So we're gonna set to US network. Well, not zero because it's a virtual machine. DHCP, yes, network properly, fine. Set the source for the installation, keep it on local. Set the host name, so we're gonna do void underscore gnome. Set the system locale, scanning for locals, and we're gonna of course set it ENUS versing E. Go to that one, ENUS. Then we're gonna set the time zone. I'm in Europe, Amsterdam. Set the root password. Then it's setting the primary username and password. So we're gonna set the primary username to Yale. Set the password. Repeat the password. Then it said, okay, what group membership? We're already a member of the wheel group, so that will be enough to perform a sudo installations and that kind of stuff. And all the others are me perfectly fine. Then we're gonna do the bootloader on dev SDA, FVDA, yeah. Normally dev SDA, but VDA. Then we're gonna partition the disk. This is the 30-dig disk. We're gonna do it in UEFI mode. We're gonna do EPT. We're gonna create a new 512 meg for the UEFI. Type to UEFI system. And we're gonna create one for root. It's gonna be file system. Write that. Yes. And then we're gonna quit. So then configure the file system and the mount points. So VDA, we're gonna set it up as VFAT. It's gonna be boot / EFI. And the big one gonna be 64. I'm gonna set it. Very careful here. And then we say done. Start the installation with safe settings. Gonna do. Set it. Okay, done. So we have set the first one EFI VFAT and the second one as EFI4. So do you want to continue? Yes, I want to continue. So it's now counting the files. I'm gonna install pretty quickly. It doesn't take that long normally. Goes pretty fast. It was pretty strange, and that it doesn't start from that USB disk. Tried several times, but I wasn't able to get it started at all. So that's pretty frustrating. But yeah, I still want to do the complete review of it, so I'm gonna use it as in a virtual machine. But I'm gonna use it as my main operating system. Just gonna install everything on it. I'm gonna use it as my main operating system. As it is a run-it system, I'm not aware of getting something like a boot time, and of course because it's a virtual machine, it doesn't really. It's faster in normal boot time than on a normal machine, because we don't have the BIOS and that kind of stuff. It goes pretty fast. So I'm not gonna test that one. I will try to do Geekbench. Not sure if that will work on a virtual machine and if really applicable for that operating system. And of course the memory and this kind of stuff will be done. That's no problem. So it's now rebuilding the init RAM FS. Then we should be able to reboot into the system. But for me, it was a bit disappointing that I couldn't start it from hardware install wasn't possible, really. But I do want to work. Do want to show you that a GNOME desktop can work very well in an installed Void Linux. And I'm very curious how it will run, because Void is similar to Arch. Could be a rolling release. But I'm very curious about this. See what kind of software versions are being installed. That I never really looked at Void Linux before. So I'm very curious to see what it is done, what it's doing, and what software versions are being installed afterwards. Yeah, let's see. Doing the last part. Yes, we're ready to reboot. Oh, good. Screen again. So we're running. We're gonna log in with my user password, and we're logged in. Clear the screen. So the next thing that we need to do is update the repositories for Void Linux. So we're gonna do sudo xbps-install. Do syu sync update, put in the password, here all the repositories are now updated, so we have to do it again to update all the software. Do it again. Here there's a lot of more information. And when this is done, we'll continue. I'll speed this bit up. So this part is done. We're now gonna install GNOME desktop environment. We're gonna install that one. So sudo xbps-install GNOME. That's the GNOME desktop environment. We're gonna do GNOME apps, and we're gonna Mesa driver. What else do I need to install? XDG user. Yes. I think this is what we need to install. Install that. Gonna accept it, and when this is done, be back. So that part was done. Clear the screen. And we're gonna make the soft links to the service for the services. So sudo ln-s /sv/network/manager. I'm gonna do that to var service. Enter password. Then we're gonna repeat that command for DDM, so it's the GNOME display manager booking window. So M. And we're gonna start up the services, the dbus, and as soon as I start this one, you will see that it will start in login screen. Yeah. So here we are, should be able to log in now. Oh, GNOME on Void Linux. Go to the settings, just screen. Do the walkthrough. devices. Normal size. So here we are, guys. A default GNOME installation. So as you can see here, this is everything is default. So wired connection, user account, and seems like it's older version of GNOME. Sound a bit more on. Not GNOME 3.36 because I missed the do not disturb button here. Let's go to the activities. It's your normal activity center where your workspaces are. Taskbar. Let's show the applications. So what do we have installed by default? We have the archive manager, boxes, builder, it's GNOME builder, calculator, calendar, character map, characters, cheese, clocks, developer help, dictionary, disk units analyzer, disks, document scanner, viewer, so your PDF files, documents for other files, evolution for your mail files, your default file browser, fonts, EHEX, Gitchi, don't know what that is, help file, image viewer, maps, and we have music, NimLive, NimIver, don't know, probably a game. For reporting bugs and programming. Not something that I will be using. Else do we have? Network tools, photos, Polari, recipes, screenshot, settings of course, sound recorder, sysprof, this. Versus ownership. Doing something with test. Testing the events that are running this moment. Just here, overview. Okay, good. Also something more for a developer than for a normal user. System monitor, terminal, text editor, gedit, tweaks, GNOME tweaks is installed by default, videos, web from GNOME. Let's go into a terminal. Size a bit. Check the memory. Currently we are at 787 use and 70. It's not a clean boot, of course, so I'll do that as a clean boot. New name A. We're running GNOME for Linux with the kernel 5.4. Not a very new one. Let me check if there are already new updates available. I think we did it. Oh, yeah, let's just check it for certainty. So, xpps-install new. Nothing to update, everything is up to date. Let's do a quick check on what version of GNOME is installed. 3.34, older version. But it was more a rolling release. Linux, and I was expecting more up-to-date GNOME version. But okay, we'll do it with this. Yeah, guys, this was the installation and the overview. Walkthrough. In the next video, we'll be making it my own again and install of the software that I want to have in the system. And I'll see you in the next one. Have fun with Linux, guys. For now.